Hi everyone, welcome to the Q&A recording of the film 70/30, playing as part of 11th European Union Human Rights Film Days. We are here with the director of the film, Fie Ambo, who is joining us from Copenhagen. Welcome, Fie.
Thank you very much. Nice to be here.
So your documentary 70/30 was the opening film at this year's CPH Docs Film Festival in Denmark. 2 years ago, we screened another documentary of you, actually, at European Union Human Rights Film Days, Rediscovery, which focuses on a group of children who develop a possible future society. Now in 70/30, you focus on a hot topic, climate change, maybe the greatest challenge of our times. Yeah. So obviously, you have a particular interest in making films about the future of our planet and ourselves. Yeah. So my first question will be, what inspired you to examine this issue and making this film?
Well, to tell you the truth, for me, it started maybe about 10 years ago when I started hearing about these climate issues that were really, really serious. And I have two children, and I began having trouble sleeping at night because I kept worrying, what will their future be like? And it seemed like no one was really listening when the scientists were talking. No one was acting. So I became more and more anxious about this subject. And I tried to find a way to, how can I as a filmmaker take on this challenge? So I started making films locally. I haven't been flying since 2014. I made these different dogmas around my filmmaking about trying to shine a light on the climate issues in many different ways, in a more poetic way than you usually see. So I made different films. Rediscovery is one of them that shines a light on the human interaction with nature. But when I saw that the politicians in Denmark were planning to make a very ambitious climate act, I thought, now finally they're taking this seriously. Finally, the grown-ups are trying to take care of the voters and the children. And I felt sort of I wanted to see, is this really true? Because I've been, you know, being anxious for so many years. So I really wanted to see what's going to happen in these negotiations, because I was hopeful, but I was also fearful that this was not going to happen. So I decided to follow the process with the camera, because that's how I understand the world. That's how I understand what's going on. I can see through my camera, and it's much easier for me to figure out what's happening than if I just read the newspapers. Mm-hmm. So that was why I started making this film. I really wanted to know, are they serious about this, or is it just talk?
Thank you for your answer. Back to the story of the film. In your film, you follow the efforts of the climate minister, Dan Jorgensen, mm-hmm. and politician Ida Auken, as mm-hmm. they try to pass the Climate Act, which aims to reduce Denmark's carbon dioxide emissions. So you also focus on a group of young climate activists who are trying to put climate protection at the top of the political agenda. So you included two different point of views in the film, politicians and young activists. Why did you choose these two perspectives, I wonder?
Yeah, it was because I think that usually when we write history, it ends up with a few people, usually white men, who sign some contracts, and then we think that history was written this way, and it wasn't. All the big solutions were made from, they came from the people. And in this situation, the whole attention on the climate issues that came from children, even people who didn't have the right to vote, they started demonstrating, and Greta Thunberg made this whole movement. They managed to get the attention that the scientists and all the grown-ups hadn't. You know, we were not able to get that traction. So for me, it was really important to show that they actually, they made this possible. It was possible because the population went to the streets and they started demonstrating, and the politician, they started listening to them because they are the future voters. So they have to be in contact with the people. For me, it's so important to tell everyone who lives in a democracy that we can use our democratic voices, and we have to do that because time is running out. So we all have to make sure that that everyone who makes decisions, they know that we are ready to make this change. Next problem is that a lot of people are not, you know, when the change comes to their neighborhood, they are really not that willing to make the change. So we have to work on all levels. We have to, you know, in local communities, we have to talk to people there and say, so maybe it's not that bad to have a wind turbine or solar panel where you live, because in Denmark, the problem now is that people don't want it. They want it globally, but they don't want it in their own backyard. So there's all the time that the responsibility is shifting. So we have to be aware that we are not pushing only the politicians, because they can't pass the laws if the public don't want it. So it's changing, the perspective is changing all the time. So I thought it was important to see the public in the streets and led by these two female activists and the decision makers, the politicians.
Mm-hmm. I think cinema is a very strong tool to maybe let people know about the, you know, what's going on in our planet. So, and I think your film creates this effect on people, on positive effect. So I have another question about the about the storytelling of the documentary. Sometimes we see a very stereotypical storytelling in these kinds of climate focused documentaries, you know, the bad versus good. Mm-hmm. On the other hand, you avoid such stereotypical storytelling in your film. Would you like to say something about this choice?
Yeah, I think it's so important in this whole agenda that we start looking at each other as human beings. I think that it's important for me when I look my participants in the eyes, if I can see they really mean it and they work hard, then I'm on their side. Then I don't want to sort of, I want us to be on the same team, even though they are opposed to each other in the film. They are all working towards a greener future. So we have to look at what are people doing? Are they doing what they're saying? And if they're doing that, we should support them. So for me, it's important not to label someone as good or bad. We are all on one team that's working for a green transition. And that can look differently and we can do it in different ways. But it's just important to focus on who's doing something, who has the power to do something, and then support that. So I think that a lot of time in journalism, it's pretty easy to just criticize anyone who's in power, and that's a bit dangerous, because you could end up with the most green people. They get worn out because they only get pushed and criticized, and there's, you know, no one is supporting them. And the climate agenda is way too important for us to fall for these cheap acts where we just you know, take out the blanket on the people in power, because we actually need green people in power. Mm-hmm. So for me, it's important not to label someone as good or bad. I just want to support anyone who's working for green transition.
Mm-hmm. I think the message of your film is very clear. I mean, if you want actual change, we need to start working together and take responsibility. So the message is really clear and I really like it. So you yourself as a climate activist, as you said in the beginning of our conversation, are we going to see more climate-focused films directed by you? Environmental issues will be on your agenda in the future as well?
Yeah, you know, I thought that next film I was going to make was going to be more like human relations or something more, you know, not climate related. But then I just thought, well, I don't see a lot of people making films about climate issues. So until I see in Denmark the next generation taking over, I'm going to keep making the films, because we need to be aware all the time. For us in the north, not a lot of people know that the climate changes are actually here now. We are being flooded and fires are burning and there's avalanches and all kinds of things happening now in the north. So that's a film that I'm researching on making. And in January and February, I'm going to edit a film about a big industrial forest in Denmark that's being rewilded. So the process of rewilding a dead forest, that's the next film. It's called Organized Wilderness. Organized Wildness. And it's a bit of a humorous film also, because it's this dilemma that people want nature, but not where I live. They want wild animals, but not too close to where I am. So it's looking at that dilemma.
Mm-hmm. We are looking forward to watch these films.
Thank you.
And I have a final question about the young activists in the film. Mm-hmm. Do you still have contact with them, Esther and Selma?
Yes.
I wonder, what do they do now? And I also wonder, how did they react to the film?
Yeah, they are still really, really active in the climate movement. Actually, now we are working a bit together and trying to make a more diverse climate movement, because in Denmark, the movement is very white. It's not very diverse. So, and it's important in the climate movement that we get as diverse as possible. So we are actually working together in trying to create a more diverse climate movement, which is super exciting. I think that they when they watched the film the first time, they were a bit surprised to see the politicians from a more humane side, because part of the fuel of being a climate activist is actually also to be angry with the politicians. So I think it sort of it didn't give them the image of the climate minister as a bad guy, and that was a bit confusing for them, I think. So I'm not sure how they feel about it now, but they also need to keep this story going that they are fighting against someone specific. And the tricky thing in the climate movement is to all the time see, is the person or the movement we need to fight, is that someone else now? Or is it maybe the big industry? Is it industrial farming? Is it, you know, instead of just the politicians? So I think the film raises these questions for them too.
Yes, I think the film raises a lot of questions about the climate change and other issues as well. But we run out of time. So thank you for sharing your inspiring film with us, Fi.
Thank you so much for showing it. I'm mm-hmm. very grateful.
And good luck with your upcoming works.
Thank you so much.